Hello everyone, welcome to my new video. In this video we are going to make a tennis ball as you have seen in the thumbnail. Now I will model the tennis ball in SolidWorks and render it in KeyShot. This is not a fully beginner's tutorial, so the prerequisite of this tutorial is you must be familiar with SolidWorks basics and material graph in KeyShot. Now without any further ado, let's jump into SolidWorks. Now to create a tennis ball, our first step is to create a sphere. To create a sphere, I will use the revolve feature, in which I will sketch a semicircle and revolve it around its diameter. So we will go to sketch, choose circle, choose front plane and click here normal to. If you can't find here normal to, then you can search here. Now I will make a circle, okay, and give it a diameter of 68 millimeter. I am currently working in MMGS unit. You can see your unit here, okay. Now I will make a central line along its center and then press escape and trim other half of semicircle, okay. Now I will use the revolve feature to revolve this semicircle around this axis, okay. Now we will go to features, revolve boss oblique base, and then here you can see our preview. I will simply click on the green checkbox and now we have created our sphere. Now our next step is to create strips of our tennis ball, which is of white color. Okay, so to create strip of our tennis ball, I will go to front plane, sketch, click normal to, and then sketch a 2D profile which look like our strip. So I will make a line then a semicircle, another line and a closing line. And now I will give it dimensions. Okay. And now we will exit the sketch. So here you can see that our sketch is at the center of our sphere. And I want to project this sketch on our surface of sphere. So how will I do that? I will go to curves, split line, and in property manager you can see our split line feature, and make sure that you work in projection menu. Okay, I will simply clear this box and here I will choose our sketch. Okay, so I will choose a sketch and here I will choose a surface on which I want to project our sketch. I will click this surface and click on green check. Now here you can see that this sketch is projected on our surface, but it is not a sketch. How I can say that? Because in feature manager tree I don't have any sketch here. So how I will create this curve into sketch? To create this curve into sketch, I will go to sketch, in drop down menu I will go to 3D sketch and go to convert entities, and now I will select all the curves. Here you can see in property manager, okay, so I will select all the curves and click on the green checkbox. Now in feature manager tree you can see here it is written 3D sketch, so I have a sketch and I can use sweep cut feature. Now I will exit the sketch, go to feature menu and select swept cut. Why I'm doing this? Because I want to make our strips of tennis ball. So make sure that you work in circular profile mode. I will click this and in path I will select this 3D sketch. Here you can see our preview. Now I will reduce the diameter to 3 millimeters. Make sure you are also working in millimeter unit. And I will press green checkbox. So here you can see our tennis ball. Now our another step is to create another body on this cut so that we can give it another material type while rendering. So how can I do this? I will go to right plane, sketch, click normal tool, and then go to 3-point arc and make an arc here roughly. Okay, so here you can see that I have some coincident relation with this edge and this point. Suppose you don't have this constraint, then what you can do that you click on this and control, press control, click on this edge and select this coincident. Again select this point, press control, select this edge and coincident and green checkbox. To use our swept boss feature, I need a close 2D profile. So to make this profile close, I will make another 3-point arc here and give it a greater dimension than previous one. Okay, now I will go to my feature, swept boss oblique base, and here I will choose our profile, this one, and our path I will choose from feature manager design tree in cut sweep this 3D sketch 1. Here you can see our preview. One important step is go to option and remove that tick in merge result. So I will remove this. Why I am doing this? Because I want to create a new body from this preview or swept boss feature. So I will click on green checkbox. Here you are not able to see two bodies, but I have two bodies. How can I see them? I will click on this surface and hide it. So here you can see that I have a strip of a tennis ball. This means I have two different bodies. So I will press Ctrl Z and our tennis ball is ready. So grab a cup of coffee and let's jump into KeyShot. Now I have imported our tennis ball in KeyShot. So you can see in scene that in tennis ball we have two bodies. One is this strip. If I hide this ball, then you can see our strip, and other is our ball with a strip cutout. So our first step is to unlink both the material. How can I do this? I will click on this, right click, material, unlink material. Okay, now I can assign different material in both bodies. Now I will go to this and go to material graph and change this diffuse to plastic. Okay, and change the color of ball from white to our tennis ball color, and you can use color code of tennis ball 00F85B and press OK. Here you can see our preview. Okay, now I will add some fuzz on the surface of our tennis ball. To do this, I will simply right click on our material graph, go to geometry, fuzz, and the output of fuzz will be connected to the input of our geometry. And then I will go to the setting of fuzz, you can see here, and make some adjustment here. So I will put our length to 3 millimeters, length variation to 0.5. Randomness to 5, radius to 0.01, density 20, segments 16, and max curve let it be 10, and then shape into cylinder. So I want to make one thing clear that if you make any changes in geometry node, then you have to execute the geometry node. Okay, every time you make any small changes, you have to execute the geometry node. You can execute it from here or simply click this button, or you can see here you can click this one also. So I will click on this. Now you can see our preview, but you can see that our fuzz material is of black color. So I will change the color of our fuzz. So how can I do this? I will simply right click on material graph, material diffuse and output of diffuse to input of fuzz, and make the color of this diffuse to the color of a tennis ball. And our code is 76E263 and okay. Now see, I have made the changes in color, but I cannot see any changes here. Why? Because I haven't executed the geometry node. So I will simply click this button and you can see our preview here. Okay, and if you want to increase the length of our fuzz, then go to fuzz, make it 3 to 4 or maybe 5. You can see no changes here. So I will execute the geometry node. And after some calculation, you can see our preview. But 5 millimeter length is very large, so I will reduce it to 3. Okay, and execute the geometry node. Okay, now you can see our ball here. I will close the material graph of this and open our material graph of strip and change this to something little grayish. Okay, and go to region menu and try to render some region of our key shot, and you can see that we are getting a good preview, but it not looks realistic. So this is because we don't have shadows and a gradient around this. So how can I do that? I will go to edit, add geometry, plane, and I will add a plane here. Okay, and locate our plane. First make it big like this. So why I'm importing this plane? I want to create some spotlight with this plane. Okay, and I will click on this plane, change it from diffuse to spotlight, and here you can see our preview. I will go to environment, and drag all black here, and go to edit, add geometry, and add a ground plane so that I can see some more reflections. Since the light of this spotlight is very high, so I will go to lumen and make it 1000. And move it a little bit far. Okay, go to environment and drag any environment you want. So I will drag this environment. Here you can see our shadow. You can also add materials to our ground plane. Go to material graph and change this to any surface you want. You can also add some texture. Okay, so I have created our tennis ball, which looks very nice. If you want to add some texture to the ground plane, you can also add some texture, like as we have seen in our thumbnail. So this is for today, guys. And if you want me to model or render any other thing, you can comment in the section below, and I will surely make tutorial on that. And if you want me to make beginner's tutorial on KeyShot, then comment in the section below. Okay, so that is for today, guys. Thank you.